talk about some of today's biggest political stories.
It's the story behind the story.
I was like, whoa.
The editorial mission driving the mainstream news cycle.
And I just kind of sat back. I was like, wow, this is it. This is the speech.
Play by the rules, instructions coming straight from the top.
He said, I was just in Washington, and people in Washington tell me that they're concerned about your tone.
Recently departed MSNBC anchor Cenk Uygur describes the talking to he alleges came from the head of the cable news network. The talking to that drove him to leave the station.
He said, I'd love to be an outsider. Outsiders are cool. But we're not. We're insiders. We are the establishment.
Former insiders and analysts we interviewed say it's this way of thinking in the mainstream TV media that leads to a 24-hour news cycle filled largely with...
Casey Anthony, the woman accused of killing her 2-year-old little girl.
You would know if this is your underpants.
We now learn Maria demanded he move out.
Has been wowing us with her style.
Coverage that an MSM defector says has cost stations their literate audience and credibility.
A lot of mainstream television news in particular is in the gutter. They're just wasting your time with Casey Anthony stories, with Anthony Weiner's wiener. It's become a national joke.
A national joke that protects ad revenue and political currency, unlike more hard-hitting stories.
They would be stories that offend big corporations and big political power. And that's why they're not covered.
It could explain why politicians become fair game only on the way down when everyone's covering it.
Maybe this is him. There he is right now.
It could explain why more reporters haven't covered, for example, a secret prison in Somalia run by the CIA. Journalist Jeremy Scahill exposed its secrets and says several other American reporters know about it, too. Instead, this was the response to his story.
In the case of CNN, didn't even mention my report and just basically reprinted a press release from the CIA saying that, you know, they were just assisting the Somali government.
It could explain why networks aren't redoubling their efforts to cover hard-hitting stories. Instead, fresh off the successful ratings of the Casey Anthony trial, you have a network like ABC hiring former kidnapping victim Elizabeth Smart to cover missing children stories.
I mean, they basically came out and said, we need to do more missing children, more missing people stories. And so that's what they're going to do. And that is going to be at a cost to other stories.
Taking away from stories that affect people on a greater scale, from jobs to inequality, poverty, wars, and police brutality. Meanwhile, you have national celebrities filling the spots of journalists.
And we are so glad now to be joined by Elizabeth Smart.
And journalists filling the spots of celebrities. When CNN's Anderson Cooper tweeted this photo, it quickly turned to fodder for Hollywood gossip blogs.
Schwarzenegger admitting he had a child with a staff member.
The direction seems to be heading ever further in the direction of sensational and tabloid, which, if Rupert Murdoch's News Corp scandal is any indication, could backfire.
Ultimately, that's you're going to lose ratings, you're going to lose viewers, and, you know, ultimately you may find yourself under investigation.
Networks that pledge to lean forward or claim to be fair and balanced, or that call themselves the most trusted name in news, see defectors leaving to find an independent outlet if they want to try to live up to those mottos. Lauren Lister, RT, Washington, D.C.